Hi, I'm Peter Taylor with the Patterns and Practice team at Microsoft. Today we'll be looking at the Automated Enterprise Business Intelligence Reference Architecture. Before we begin, let's talk about Azure Reference Architectures. Each one is a set of recommended practices and considerations for scalability, availability, manageability, and security. Some include artifacts on GitHub, so you can use them out of the box, or you can use them as a basis for your own solution. And who is the intended audience for this reference architecture? Well, it'll be useful to you if you collect data from a variety of sources and want to load it incrementally. There's also some logic in this reference architecture for using polybase with binary fields that exceed 8,000 bytes, but we'll get to that later. The scenario for this reference architecture is that we're the fictitious company Wide World Importers, a wholesale novelty goods importer and distributor. We're looking to expand, and we want to focus on the cities that have the highest population growth, but zero sales. So let's look at the first part of this reference architecture. In this scenario, our sales data is stored on-premises. The sample data we're using is the Wide World Importers sample database. The code artifacts in GitHub include scripts and deployment templates to set this up for you. But the sample database doesn't include population information, so we'll get that from an Azure storage account that hosts sample data. There's more information on that on the documentation. The next part is ingestion and storage. We use data factory pipelines to orchestrate and automate data movement. Blob storage is used here because Azure Data Factory is configured to stage the data into blob storage before it's loaded into SQL Data Warehouse using Polybase. This results in the sales and population data linked together in production tables. Next up is the analysis stage, and we use Azure Analysis Services for this. All we do here is create a tabular model and deploy it. The result of this analysis is what we want, a list of cities with a high population growth rate and zero sales. Finally, we use Power BI for visualization of the analyzed data. If you're not familiar with Power BI, it's a suite of powerful business analytics tools that make it easy to generate visualizations. And during development of this reference architecture, the Patterns and Practice team found that Polybase has a limitation when importing large binary fields. We found this out because the geography information in the sample population database can be very large. To solve this problem, a query splits the data into 8,000 byte chunks and inserts them into a temporary storage table. Then these chunks are reassembled using the pivot operator during the final stage of ingestion into Azure SQL Data Warehouse. The documentation has a thorough discussion of this technique and also includes guidance for incrementally ingesting data, data cleansing, and supporting data with slowly changing dimensions. For this reference architecture and many others that cover networking, security, identity, and other scenarios, visit the Azure Architecture Center at aka.ms/architecture. And thanks for watching.